So Stuart, a new contract at Leeds United, how does that feel?
Buzzing, delighted. Really happy that I've signed a new deal, obviously. I've always said it's where I want to be. This is home for me. You know, when I first came into the club, the fans took me in as one of their own, and I felt that really special connection with them. And that's grown stronger within the last few years. So hopefully it can get even stronger as the years go on. But I'm delighted. I'm happy that I'm signing. My family are here. They this is home for them as well. So I'm over the moon.
How do you reflect on the 6 years so far here?
It's been a journey. I said in previous interviews that when you come in, this place is special, but from the outside looking in, you know how big the club is, but when you're inside it, it's an incredible club. And my 6 years here has been a journey, a lot of ups and downs throughout that, more ups in the last couple of years rather than downs. So it's been a roller coaster of a journey, and I've loved every minute of it, and hopefully there's more to come. I think last season was a benchmark for us, and hopefully we can progress this year.
And how do you keep sort of hitting the targets and hitting those requirements that moving up through the divisions has obviously brought, but that last season playing in the Premier League and doing as well as you did?
I think it's a self-belief, believing in yourself that you're good enough to play at this level, and obviously having the belief of your manager and your teammates in you as well. That's huge. It gave me confidence to play, to perform at this level. And I think for me, the biggest thing's self-belief and having the confidence of the manager to put me in any position. It's not easy. It is difficult. Of course it is. But I've got a willingness to learn as well. I want to try and improve every game. And, I look after myself off the pitch as well, which is huge at this level, because you can't get away with it. You've got to maintain your fitness and try and be as fit as possible to play at this level. And we've been provided with the best facilities possible to do that. And then it's just about looking after yourself then.
And how do you see your role within the squad, maybe off the pitch, Stuart? You're in that age bracket now where people are talking about you being experienced, but yeah, there's a lot of talented young players. Do you see yourself as a kind of a senior figure in that sense?
Absolutely. I think obviously with my age, I'm 30 now, but I've been about the club, and I know what it means to people to represent this club. I know what it means to the fans, to how much it means to them to have a team that wants to play for the club as well. And I feel that there's a number of us in this group that are leaders, maybe not on the pitch the loudest, but certainly off the pitch we can put our arm around young kids when they need it and try and give them advice, and obviously we can learn off them as well. They're enthusiastic and a lot of the kids, and there's a lot of talent, and they keep pushing us as well. And but it's important that us senior lads, we really try and keep the group together, and I think that's a huge part of what we're about. We have a fantastic group of players here, and everybody's really close to each other, and I think that's what's needed, to keep this club going in the right direction. And obviously, talent takes over then as well. Individual players that have got the talent to really drive us forward then. But I think it's important that we have that core of the group that maintains standards here and doesn't let anybody slack.
I mean, that's a great thing for you, isn't it? You've made friends for life here within the squad, haven't you? And this is your home now, isn't it?
Yeah. Look, no matter what would have happened, whether signed a new deal or didn't, or in the coming years, no matter what happens, I think this will always be my home. My kids are growing up here, my family's happy here, they're settled, and it's a special place. It's a bit like home for me. The people are nice. And the fans have really taken to me. As I said before, I've got that special connection, and it means a lot to me. It means a lot to my family that they're comfortable in this environment. And this is a good place to play football. It's a fantastic club, of course it is, and fantastic people backing it as well.
And first day of pre-season testing now. How much has pre-season changed, Stuart, from when you first started playing?
Yeah, it's changed a lot. All the testing and stuff, I never done that when I first signed my professional contract. We've done a lot of it, to be fair, at Brentford. They were quite advanced then as well. But now, every season you come back, there seems to be more and more tests to do. And it's good because it's given us the best platform to perform when the season finally arrives. And nobody looks forward really to pre-season. I think the only thing you look forward to is to seeing your teammates again after not seeing them the majority of them in the summer. But it's good. We've had a good rest, and now we come back and we're ready to work. Obviously, these first couple of days is just more about testing and stuff, and then it starts to ramp up a bit, and you know, we'll be sure to be ready when the season starts.
And before you know it, that'll happen. So what's the mindset going into this season, particularly after what you achieved last year?
Well, I think we've set that level. We set that benchmark last season, you know, of where we want to be. We know that expectations now is going to rise, the pressure's going to rise. There's going to be more microscope on us because of how we done last season. People will be looking at us, wanting us to fall, wanting us to fail, because that's the way the football world works. And especially at a club like us, you know, not everybody likes us, but we like that, and that gives us a pressure. But it's one that we've got to embrace and look forward to it. Of course, we've got to be realistic, but it's important that, you know, we aim high, we're ambitious, and we need to aim high and try and catch them teams that finished above us last season. It's going to be difficult, of course it is, but, you know, the club are probably going to bring players in that's going to try and improve us. And, you know, we've got to work harder than we did last year. But it's one we're looking forward to.
And just finally, Stuart, I suppose you got a taste of fans being back in, didn't you, on that last game?
Yeah.
That must be a huge thing to look forward to, isn't it, playing a full season in front of the fans?
Look, everybody says that football's nothing without fans, and that last game was, you know, it was great to have them back. The noise they made, and there only was, I don't know, what was there, 8 or 10,000? Mm. We're watching the Euros, and we see what fans bring to it. You know, I seen Wembley the other night. I don't know how many was there, but, you know, the atmosphere was incredible, and you see the joy that it brings to people. And we want that as well. You know, this club has waited a long time to be back in the big time, and for the fans to miss out on that last year was disappointing, and disappointing for us as well. We haven't experienced that, and we want it. You know, I'm sure they'll raise the roof off Elland Road when they're back in, and we miss them as well, because they're our driving force at times when we're struggling. You know, they get us over the line, and you know, we can't wait to have them back.